Top Media is back. Yes, we're back after a long break and we'll be bringing you the best top 5, 10, 15s and more on YouTube. For a second I thought you forgot about us. Well, you're not getting rid of me that easily. Anyways, thanks for all the subscribers who decided to stick around and enjoy. Oh, and don't forget to support us on Patreon if you like, which we finally got around to launching. A link is in the description. Check it out, it would be very much appreciated.
Alright, listen, we've all been lazy and hungry enough to eat food straight out of a jar, or a pot, or a box, or whatever it's eaten to begin with. Or maybe just even with your fingers. Of course, one of the more satisfying eating food out of a tub habits is associated with Nutella. Oh, come to me. You're all going in my mouth. I don't need a utensil. I'm going to use my hands. Sorry, I kind of lost my composure there for a moment. Second up though, even though the noise can gross out other people, which is fair enough, it's very odd. It's quite satisfying for some people to crack their knuckles. Personally, it freaks me out, but hey, some people must love it, otherwise they wouldn't do it all the time. And who knows about the myth regarding whether or not it damages your joints? It may do, it might not. But either way, cracking your knuckles is too pleasing for many to resist. Sometimes it's simply not worth the effort of getting yourself a whole glass just for a gulp of your favourite beverage or milk or whatever you're into. I'm not asking questions. Who hasn't taken a drink directly out of the carton? Come on, hands up. Right, you can put your hands down now. We're not actually interested. I mean, sure, it is kind of a horrible thing to do if you live with other people and they're going to be drinking out the same thing, but they probably do it as well. Come on. Don't lie. We know you do. Not sure about you, but personally, peeling plastic off a brand new product, like a television or a phone, you know, the little thing you get on the front of it, ooh, strangely satisfying. Unless you're one of those weird people that leave the plastic on thinking it'll preserve the quality of it. No, it just means that you'll have a phone that looks terrible for a year, rather than having a phone that looks nice and shiny for about a month and then gets covered in scratches. Still, live in the moment. Of course, no one likes getting zits or spots on their face, but be honest, there is a secret amount of addictive joy that comes when it reaches that perfect popping point. Getting to squeeze all of the gross pus out is a satisfying reward for suffering through a dermatological disaster. Have you ever tried vacuum packing something? Anything, honestly. After watching it in Breaking Bad, I do this every day, as it's just an incredibly pleasing thing to do. Obviously, I don't do it with vast piles of money. That'd be great, but no, I'm not an international drug dealer, and please stop insinuating that I am. Maybe it's the swiftness and ease of sucking all the air out of something, I don't know. But whatever it is, I like doing it, I like watching it, and I'm sure that other people do too. So most of us have probably experienced this during our school days. Back then, it was unintentional. You know, we didn't know what we were doing. We were children, that was fine. But now, there's something kind of very pleasing about putting PVA glue on your hands for the sole purpose of then peeling it off when it gets dry. It's also very satisfying with wax, dipping your finger in candles. Don't do it, it's dangerous, but at the same time, it does feel kind of nice. Let's admit it, nobody likes getting them in the first place, of course, but there are a few things as immediately satisfying as getting rid of a wedgie. Oh, they've been riding all the way up there. It's not nice, it's not comfortable, but if you're lucky, you can find a private location to just take a moment, sort it out, get it done. Sometimes though, it's just gotta be done in public. Everybody understands, come on. Although you can tell it smells toxic and it's probably not good, the smell of gasoline fumes when you're pumping gas or, you know, just hanging around at garages, not gonna ask questions, it's something that a lot of people, myself included, really, really like. It's strangely pleasant, probably shouldn't be. Just don't smell it for longer than you should because it actually isn't good for you. I know that may come as a shock, but it's probably not a good idea. Stop huffing petrol, guys. It won't help. Many find it almost irresistible to pop just one bubble. I keep going until there's none left in the world. Obviously, it's an ongoing mission that's going to take me most of my life. And I'm sure that lots of you are sitting there nodding your head agreeing right now. Bubble wrap is addictive. And the problem is, if you do pop all the bubbles, it's not bubble wrap anymore. It's not useful. It's just a sheet of plastic that needs to go in the bin. The question of how you achieve your bubble wrap popping is all down to a matter of taste. I personally like to start off with individual ones, very much like the popping zits, just enjoying the individual ones, but after a while you can't resist. You can grab a whole bundle of it and twist it like a towel and then it goes and all crunchy and it's great. Or you can just put it on the floor and jump up and down on it. Pretend you're a child. Let's be honest, you are a child. You know, you might look like a grown-up, but we're all still children. I don't care how you do it, just do it. Let's go and I'm going to go and find some bubble wrap right now. I'll see you later.
Thanks for watching another Top Media video. Don't forget to hit that very important bell icon, the subscribe button, and to support us on Patreon. As they say, pennies make pounds, and your support would go a very long way for our channel.